And welcome to the round two. This end is great. We have three cyclers, Fulminator Mage, and a Cascade card. That's just exactly what you wanna your hand look like. And it looks like we're playing against a rock deck. Seems like Abzan or Jund, which is historically the best matchup for this deck. So let's just go turn one on top lane, get ready for a cyclers. Because my opponent doesn't even have discard spell, which is the only way to beat this deck, basically. For Jund, I mean. So maybe this is a Tarmogoyf. Block Crypt. Wow, this art looks bad. What is it? Okay, say that we're fine. So this is not Jund. This is looks like Dredge. I don't know. Dredge doesn't usually play Sedgy Wayfinder. Just a weird deck. Okay, so this is the reveal card. I'm gonna cycle for... let's start with this. Then next turn I'm gonna probably fetch for another 3 damage land. Maybe. We'll see, because we also don't actually need the green mana for Violent Outburst because of Demonic Tread, and he has a Sedgy Wayfinder. So we can just wait. Oh, he milled Gurmagangler. I didn't really see that coming, but Gurmagangler being milled means that it's gonna have a 5/5. Unless we draw off Hero Markup. So maybe we just wait a little bit until we have a very big board. Crazy Salvage, wow. His matchup is odd because he's gonna have a lot of creatures in the graveyard for when we outburst in. So let's see what does he pick up. Oh, let look, Rift Crawler, you can cast it if you have a zombie in play. So I can't cast the all of three thus far, but once he has a one in play, let's say a Gurmagangler, or I don't even know how many other zombies do you have. Like Lothless Troll, probably. Okay, so he picked Footed Foothills. I want to cycle first and then see, because maybe I just want to get a swamp here. Hopefully I draw a Copperland Gorge. Blackleaf Glyph, yeah, I have to take a 3 damage here, unfortunately. And then I will probably just Fulminator Mage away the Blood Crypt. My opponent has Voodoo Foothills in his hand. I can also just cycle these two guys. But I feel like Fulminator Mage, his land might be relevant. He has a lot of cards in his hand. I also don't care about leaving this on top for blocking. Maybe he has something like Vengevine or stuff in his deck. So I want to go after... Maybe he doesn't even have a mountain, a basic mountain. So he has to fetch for, let's say, a Stomping Ground. Then I can kill it. And it's going to be out of red mana. I don't know. I'm just assuming. Just another Block Crypt. Okay. That's what Jund does. He only has a Block Crypt and a Stomping Ground. So you can easily cut him over it. If he doesn't have, of course, Blackleaf Glyph. Alright, so Lothless Troll, it's interesting. I don't think he can regenerate. I don't think it can regenerate with the with the living end. It's just a sacrifice, I think. So yes. Okay, so now I can cycle and play Full Miniature Mage. Full Miniature Mage, I can kill that land, but I think that I'd rather just block the Lothar Troll. You can discard it a lot. Discard a lot of cards, and if you play Vengevine, I can just block the Vengevine. So I might as well just pass and cycle end of turn. He chose not to reanimate a Gravecrawler because he wanted to leave mana tap for Lothar Troll, even though we don't have any way to kill it, I think. Like, Shriek Maw doesn't kill a black creatures. Clear creature. Okay, so discarded Vengevine. Yeah, this is... So you can go Vengevine and then reanimate two Gravecrawlers. Yeah, that's the combo of the deck. Hopefully it doesn't have more Vengevines. He does have more Vengevine. Oh, no. I mean, I couldn't have just Living End there. I would have put into play three Gravecrawlers and a Gurmagangle. Wow, three Vengevines. Jeez. Am I dead? I think I'm dead at this point. Gravecrawler doesn't have haste, at least. I'll block that and take 13 damage. It's not lethal. Unless he has... Oh, no, yeah. It's not lethal. Wow, three Vengevine. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I think I had to take the green source here. But... And I only drew the Corpulent Gorge the turn after. If I didn't, no. Okay. Hopefully, let me block here. Doesn't have a lightning bolt. Please let me block. Oh, this is trample. Oh, I'm dead. I'm exactly dead. 4, 8, 13, 14. Wow. I didn't see that coming. That's funny. Yeah, I'm dead, no? Did I miscount it? 3, 8, 13, 14, exactly dead. Yeah, the stomping ground killed me. This stomping ground killed me. For one time, I didn't draw a fairy mock-up. It was so important. Yes. I'm dead. Okay. All right. What do we want? We don't want Shriekmaw. We don't want Ricochet Trap. We don't want Ingachiwa. We don't want Brindle Boar. I don't think we don't want anything here. I don't know about Alan Schrider, maybe it's just bad. Alan Schrider doesn't look good, but the rest just looks bad. Maybe I want to board in just the Ingachiwa because it's just better than Alan Schrider, and the Ingachiwa might be effective against, I don't know. Relic? You can't play Relic. You cannot play Relic. So Shriek Maw, what does it kill? It doesn't kill anything relevant. Brindleboard. Doesn't really do anything. Whatever, let's just play Avalanche Rider. Yeah, let's go with this. Playing first for game 2, and wow, this one is bad. I have 0 cyclers. 0. But with Fairy Macabre. And we have a lot of cycler in our deck. I hate Simic Spirit Guide, that's why I hate it. For PT Atlanta. Was it Atlanta? Yes. The PT Eldrazi. Before we discovered Eldrazi, I played for Living End a little bit and I really hated Seems very guide there. So pulling again, pulling mulligan to 6. We don't have a great hand, but Fairy Macabre can be very relevant against him, and at least we have the Cascade cards. Maybe this was Mulligan too. Faithless Looting, sure. Well, Garrigrave Troll, Bloodcast. I might just cash in my Fairy Macabre. The thing is that if I exile, I mean, I have to exile the Bloodcast because that's a recurring thing and I really don't want to see it around. And I don't know about Golgari Troll or Faithless Looting. We're even supposed to exile the Golgari Troll. Yeah, so let's just take these two out. Dredging 6 can lead off to pretty annoying things. This is a different take on a dredge deck rather than with Insular Neonate and Prized Amalgam. And here it comes. Oh no, Fulminator Mage. I was about to say the classic turn 3 Sima Spirit Guide, but Fulminator Mage made things easier. Gonna just kill right away a Blood Crypt. If your opponent doesn't have any play on turn 2 and you kill him a land, it most likely doesn't. It's not gonna have any play the turn after as well. Okay, more Blood Crypts. Alright, maybe it does have something to play. Nope, just the top land. Just make sure that we can take him out over Gruntube as well. Alright, so let's cast this Simon Spirit Guide. It's not that bad because make our Demonic Tread live. We cannot cast Demonic Tread unless there's a target, so there it is, a target for it. Now there's probably gonna be a Faithless Looting. Or just something else. Arbor Decay. Okay. Alright. I don't mind this. I think I will Violent Outburst. And maybe. Yeah, do it now so they can kill him a Blood Crypt. I do it now so that my opponent doesn't have any creatures in the graveyard. It's a relevant thing. So let's see what's his top 3 card. Okay, Dark Blast, you can have it. And I think I want to mana screw him, so I'm gonna destroy Overgrown Tomb and give him Dark Blast Salvage, or maybe yeah, Dark Blast Salvage looks fine. If you want to use Dark Blast and Dredge for milling the top card that I gave him, that's totally reasonable. I'm gonna shut him off. So the point is that I should probably shut him off red. But since he has Grizzly Savage on top and I don't think he has another land, I want to take this out. You can't just have a land and flashback Faithless Looting. But I don't think he has another land. He played basic Swamp, where he could have played other land, other lands tapped, for example. Maybe he has two Darkbless to kill my Fairy Macabre. Kuruma Gangler, okay. Okay, now I think I'll go for a very aggro plan of just casting a Demonic Tread. Well, I have four. Demonic Tread here. Not gonna play Living End. And just attack. It's funny that these kind of cards also have a text sometimes. This Grimmergangler can't block, and bam, takes 7. Maybe 6 if you want to cast Dark Blast. It doesn't. Okay, now he's going to draw Grisly Salvage. That he can't cast. I'll make this card unable to block once again. And do it again next turn. Alright, so we managed to mana screw our opponent. Oh, he drew Bloodstained Mire, just not to play it. Okay, whatever, we keep doing this. Who would have imagined this end for this game? Just 3 Demonic Tread in a row in order to make our guys unblockable. Okay, I don't think anything changes. That's just that our sideboard doesn't have anything in order to fight this deck, so let's go with this. Game 3 against Dredge. And yes, let's keep this. Okay, no turn 1 play for opponent, it's always good news. And his Expedition block ripped it. Alright, seems like no turn to play. No, maybe he just wanted to go. Yeah. Weird. That's not a very good hand. If you just don't play anything on turn 1 and pass on turn 2. Okay, here we can actually play Violent Outburst, but I don't think it's worth enough to reanimate just a Straight Right and a Carbid Monstrous. So I think I will pass and just cycle Jungle Weaver. Opponent is not in a hurry of doing anything. Maybe kept a hand with, let's say, Fairy Macabre or stuff like that. Or a Lothar Troll. Lothar Troll is very annoying because it means that my opponent can just discard creature in response to... Oh, maybe I should have... Oh, no, I can't actually Violent Outburst because... I don't have... green. So let's cycle this. Oh, we drew Fairy Macabre, but that's very lucky. Very lucky. Okay, so now I can just pass the turn and at some point, maybe I should have played the Fulminator Mage, but I feel that this is still fine. Because I wanted to reanimate Instant Speed. Yeah. I might just wait until he puts everything in play and then just reanimate. Gridcrawler number 1 and Gridcrawler number 2. Vengevine's in play. Yeah, I think I played well, not playing Fulminator Mage. Now is attacking with... what? No, I misclicked. Whatever. We would have We would have played our Violent Outburst combat too. There's not really a misclick for him. I mean, it is definitely a misclick, but not that. Oh no, we can't cycle Dress Shot Minotaur. Oh yes, we do, sorry. I forgot. So let's cycle this. Let's cycle this. Exile this and play this. I don't want to cast Fairy Macabre, maybe my opponent wants to do something here, like discarding a creature for Lothlet Troll. It doesn't. So, do I want to? No, I don't think I care about the Blood Ghast in his graveyard. You can have it. Let's just reanimate all this stuff. And then kill a Blood Crypt. Yeah. Lot of damage coming through, and then I think I'm very close to winning. Yes, one damage. All right, so opponent, even if it didn't have any turn to play, you went for a very big turn three, very big. But likely our deck is designed that you can't just put whatever you want in play, but at some point it's gonna wrath your own board and like reverse the board. It was a cool match, and I hope you enjoyed. Let's see you next match.